So guys, here we start on the tabletop. I've drawn out the clock just so you can see orientation. The first color will be from 10 o'clock to 2 o'clock. The second color goes from 10 o'clock to 4 o'clock. And the third color goes from 10 to 7, but then it also carries on back to 2. And you'll see that how I paint it. So we base it in Dark Angel's Green. So now we're onto the first color. Like I said, 10 to 2, I've drawn on here the orientation for the clock. At 10 o'clock, it's a very hard highline because you want it to be the sweeping part. At 2 o'clock, you try and blend it into the previous color. Now we move on to Goblin Green. Again, a hard highline at 10 o'clock. And then we're going to draw the paint back to the previous color to approximately 4 o'clock. And on this color here, again, hard highline at 10. We'll draw it back to about 7 o'clock. Now, don't do a hard highline at 7 because it just wouldn't look right. So here we're sweeping it all the way back to 2 o'clock on the outside perimeter of the screen. Now we'll draw two circles to orient that it looks like radar. Now I also really highlight the sweeping part there and draw it back, blend it back. And here we're just going to put a couple blips all across the screen. Now it doesn't show very good on paper, the wash, but the next step is washing the entire screen. Now that sort of blends these green colors together. And now I go back with Scorpion Green and really highlight that sweeping part and blend it back. Guys, this technique can be applied to any radar screen, whether it being a Space Marine bike, or this part here is off the Rhino kit. And if you look closely, you'll see there's four dots around the radar screen: 10 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 5 o'clock, and 7 o'clock. Well, those are the exact four points that I want you to orient the paint to, so it works out good. One step I did not include on the tabletop portion was adding the gloss varnish. It really makes it look like it's an actual screen then.
For the Emperor!